Okay, hey. So in this very brief talk, I want to show you something very small, nifty thing I thought would be fun to show at some point. Let me see, where do I have it? Lightning talk. Yeah, so the idea is customizing MediaWiki skin actions with SMW. In fact, I did that on my own homepage for some time. The idea was you have all the data and you know much about the pages. You have extra information that MediaWiki doesn't have. So couldn't you use that to make your interface a bit little bit nicer? And in fact, you can. And what I want to show here in this particular demo, but you can do anything you like, is the option to have a download link up here. So I want to have, okay, here's a page, here's a discussion, and I would like to have also, let's see, open that in a new tab. I would like to have something like this, where here I have a particular page which has something to download, my slide set, and I would like to have a download tab for this. So in particular, I would like this to happen. Maybe I can increase the font a bit. I would like this to happen based on some semantic property. So I have prepared a little property here. So set download URL. So download URL is the property, and I directly paste it in here, the URL from the actual file on the server. One could do something different. Maybe I didn't have time for that, so I save that. And what I get now it's a bit big, because there's no space up here, so it's something like that, where if I click it, I will get just those slides. So that is a nifty little thing one could like to have. So how do you do it? This is the code. It's a bit lengthy because I entered comments as well, but you can see basically these are 20 lines of code, which you can directly paste into your local settings to do that. So I want to use the rest of my talk to just tell you what's happening here and why it works. Because I think everybody who has seen PHP before or hasn't even or has seen some other programming language can easily figure out many other things you could do in just the same way. I mean, this is just an example. You could enable all kinds of code injection attacks on your website on your own responsibility, of course. Warning up front, if you do that, there's always a danger that if you insert data that somebody entered on your wiki into the HTML part of the wiki, you have to be careful, obviously. And if you do that as a link, in this case, it's not so dangerous because links are already links. But if you insert arbitrary text, you should better escape it to make sure nobody changes your web page. Okay, so what's happening here briefly? I register a hook, which is a little function that works on a certain activity in MediaWiki. I looked that up in the documentation yesterday, which hooks that is. It's called on skin template navigation that allows you to change the navigation links up there. And in that hook, I take my title. So this is a global variable in PHP. It's a WG title. It should contain the title. If it doesn't, I just stop here because sometimes maybe it does something else. Then all I have to do in SMW is to create two objects. One little object which represents the page I'm on. We call these objects data items, hence this DI here. So all I have to do is say make a new page DI from the title I have here, make a new property DI, and here's my property name. So I have an underscore here. It's a database name, but otherwise it's just a name. And once I have these two objects for my page and my property, I find all the values of that property, and this is done in one call too. So yeah, there's one call saying get me a store, and from the store get the properties which this page has for this property, and I will get an array back of all the values. Then I check if this array has more than zero entries. I just get the first one. This is done with this reset statement here. Say give me the first init. I don't care if there are many URLs, I still will use only one. I check again if this is actually a URI, otherwise I'm out of luck. Maybe somebody changed the property type and it isn't actually a URL anymore, so I'm not going to do anything. So if this is still a URI, I get the URL by saying get URI, which is a string, and then I update this field in MediaWiki. So this is how MediaWiki allows you to update these actions. You can here also, this is where the text download comes from. I could also write something different here to make it not called download. And here I have the URL. And I could also use something else than namespaces if I want the tab to be on the other side of the navigation. So here I have it on the left. I could also put it on the right or inside here. This is all possible easily or I could create many tabs inside here, whatnot. So this is it, and in the end I return true because it's a hook, you always have to do that. Okay, so that's all from my side. It's on the wiki. It's temporarily enabled on that side as well. I'm not sure if we leave it there or not. But just as a little inspiration, how you could actually do interesting little nifty things on your sites. Okay, that's all. Thanks.